doubt it, they're gonna pretty much be the same. They are pressing that.
Five players and a six man.
Whoa. Now that's hard, because I've seen some of the greats, you know.
Regardless of positions, it can be five. Give me five players and a six man.
See, being from Winston-Salem, I can go back to my middle school, high school days when I saw Earl Monroe, Bobby Dandridge, Pee Wee Kirkland, Mike Davis of Virginia Union. I'd have to go back to Norfolk State to Hookshot Grant.
How good were those Norfolk State teams? I saw they scored a lot of points, no three-point line, no nothing. Just how good, just talk about how good they were.
They could beat most Division I programs in the country today. CIAA was loaded with what we call today Division I talent. And in a lot of ways, those players that you see now playing on television were players who probably would have been at CIAA schools or even now MEAC schools. I think that's the task for historical Black colleges and universities. We're going to have to go back and get that high quality student athletes that we once had in large numbers in our league that are now all out and all over the country. And I think if we do that, this league is going to reach epic proportions as it did back in the day.
All right, back to your team before we go. So you gave me a lot of guys. So go ahead and give me your five.
I'll do it this way. Consummate point guard Teddy Blunt from Winston-Salem State. I thought was just an outstanding floor general. Two guard score, I would have to say Earl Monroe, I saw as an outstanding player. As a center, I would have to say Rick Mahorn was very, very strong in the center position. At a three position, probably, it's a toss up of so many of those. The kid that played in Elizabeth City, Mike Gale, later on played for the San Antonio Spurs, just an outstanding player. And again, I would have to probably include Charles Oakley in there or Ben Wallace. In that power forward position, and one of those could be my sixth man.
And who's your coach?
Without a doubt, I would have to say Clarence Big House Gaines, because I saw them so much. I thought Gaines had some tremendous talent come to Winston-Salem, and he did a lot with it. They went on and won the national championship, but I'm very respectful for the coaches that have been in the CIAA league. I think it's a league that had what I call a number of Hall of Fame coaches. When you think of Bobby up Elizabeth City,
Bobby Vaughn
from Elizabeth City. When you think about Dave Robbins from Virginia Union, Harold Dean from Virginia State. When you think about, what was my guy's name over at North Carolina A&T? Cal Irvin at North Carolina A&T. And, you know, there were some great coaches out there in the CIAA that were doing very, very well that I think were Hall of Fame coaches.